Begin.
Nutrition Club. The April meeting will be Thursday, April 26th, during second lunch. Still need prom tickets? Attention seniors. A list is posted in the front office of the 2012 American Red Cross Red Cord recipients. Any questions? See Mrs. Rattermaker. Students. Interested in tutoring? Please see Mrs. Bartlett. That's all your announcements for today.
Oh dear.
So yesterday was the 29th, so that must mean that plus one is. So that means today's 30th. By golly gee whiz, I wonder what happened today in history.
First, we go off across the pond to Germany. It was year 1935. Adolf Hitler, depressed after recent defeats to the Allies, made the fateful decision to take his own life.
Next, we travel to Vietnam. It was the year 1975, and after the lengthy period of time, 19 years and 180 days to be exact, the Vietnam War came to a close with the Communist North, led by Ho Chi Minh, coming out victorious. Lastly, we go to Bangladesh, where in 1991, over 130,000 lives were taken in a catastrophic cyclone. Thank you for joining us for this day in history.
Wow, isn't this day just wonderful? Wait, you guys hear that? Yep, it's overtones. Let's learn about them.
Why do different instruments sound different from each other? What creates the specific sound of someone's voice? Why can you hear pitches and chords that aren't being produced? The answer to all these questions is overtones.
Sometimes they are hidden. Sometimes you might not hear them.
Say a D is played. That D tone is amplified by higher sound frequencies that occur simultaneously with the tone of the D. These other frequencies are termed overtones. Each overtone reinforces the fundamental note, making it louder. Timbre, or the color of a sound which differentiates certain sounds from others, is produced in this way. It creates the unique sound of any instrument or any sound at all. For example, the following is a demonstration on how overtones create a whole sound. Notice as each overtone is added that the fundamental note gets louder.
And now we add the second harmonic. Third harmonic. As you can see, there are three slides here. And it's starting to resemble a saw shape. We are going to add this harmonic here.
What is really interesting about overtones is the effect they have on a certain combination of notes. When you hear a band or a choir sing really well, you don't really know why they sound well, but self-consciously you do. This effect is produced by overtones that are pronounced by the rich chords.
Overtones are notes that are higher than the rest of the chord.
This is a fifth. These two notes together will create a third note that is not originally being produced at all, because their individual overtones overlap and in themselves become louder. For example, in the upcoming fifth, listen for this note. No one is singing it at all.
Re.
Some bands and vocal groups are so good at creating overtones that they sound much, much larger than they actually are. For example,
my heart.
Thank you.
Wow, aren't overtones amazing?
Now we're off for an adventure with John.
Oh boy!
Tonight we're hunting crabs. You have to be very careful.
So what is this dangerous profession they call crab hunting? Sounds like a lot of foolish thrill-seeking, doesn't it? Oh, how far from that it is. It's actually a highly precise pursuit of a crustacean, using the same techniques our ancestors did many moons ago. Crab hunting takes place all over the world by a wide array of people. Sounds pretty complicated and dangerous, doesn't it? Nah, not really, actually. You just kind of find a crab hole in the sand, and you dig it up, and then you pull a crab out. Unfortunately, due to national rules and regulations, blah, 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 we can't show you the actual crab catching process on video. So, we're going to show you how they're cooked instead.
We are now at the condo with our crab and our pot. It's time to cook. All right, first step is to get a pot big enough so the crab won't crawl out of it.
Wait,
too small.
I didn't even see it.
Much too small, because he can just reach his legs up and crawl right over there.
Yeah. Talking right now?
This is a more acceptable pot size. What you want to do is basically just fill the pot with water deeper than the crab. You want to get the water very hot so the crab will die instantly when you put it in. No animal cruelty. We do not hurt animals other than killing them and eating them. All right, now that our water is at a slow boil, we are going to enter the crab into the water. Come closer. You have to be very wary of his pinchers, and he's not going to want to go quietly. He shudders a little bit, and he should be dead fairly shortly. Now we're going to remove our crab from the cooking pot. Careful, the water is warm. Hot. A delicacy. Gulf Shores crab.
Dad, like, you put him in there when he was alive?
The poor little thing.
Oh, yeah. See him try to crawl out of there.
Okay.
They're mad. Yes.
They don't like it.
They kiss and they are mad.
Look at all that meat. Maybe it's a butter on it now.
Tastes like chicken.
It's actually pretty good.
Oh, you're so bad. Anything?
Butt of the knife to smash it. This is what we're after right in here. This little chunk of meat. Oh yeah, there it is. That sounds really good. And that's what all the work's for, ladies and gentlemen. That little piece of meat. But if you were down here tasting it with me, you would surely agree that it is every bit worth it.
Great adventure. I was just working out for Barn Ball. Speaking of Barn Ball, watch this.
Ooh. Oh. Oh. Huh? Yeah.
Welcome to Barn Ball.
Warm-ups, conditioning, layups, Mike-ins, shooting, 5 ball moves with shooting, and hydration.
Barn Ball? What is Barn Ball?
Barn Ball was established in 1998 using mainly fencing, road signs, and perspiration. It was originally a hayloft before being transformed into a state-of-the-art facility. Before some events, even, slight repairs are common. Barn Ball is also a part of the Schneider Basketball Association, in result that the rims are 9 feet rather than the standard 10, and also the floor is 34 feet long rather than the standard 94.
Did you know that? Well, now you know.
My favorite part about barn ball, dunking and blocking shots. And my favorite dunk would probably be what I like to call the thunder dunk. I jump up and put the ball behind my head with two hands and slam it home. Just right over people, whoever's in the way.
Thank you for watching.
Boy, that was a lot of trash talking, barn ball. You know, I had the craziest dream last night. I was in a Lego battle.
What a day at work. Time for bed. Hopefully no more bad dreams.
No, that dream. I'm gonna be late to donate blood.
Donate blood. You never know who you might save.
So, did you hear about the blood drive?
No.
Oh, it's this Monday.
Really?
Yep.
So, are you gonna donate?
I really just can't handle needles.
You're afraid of needles? But the needles are really small and virtually painless.
Yeah, but the whole process just isn't that safe.
Giving blood can save 3 lives.
Yeah, one person donating won't make that big of a difference.
Are you sure?
Your excuses should be the things that are fading away. Give blood.